Thank you very much. Alan, do you want to come in at the stage, or do you want to say your prayer for later?
Yeah, I'll just make a couple of
points. Yeah, I'm sure.
Points. I think it's been a really fascinating.
I'm going to speak up. I apologise for the noise, everybody. They work all night today.
I think it's been a really fascinating set of comments that I'm hearing, reflections from all around the world, really around this unifying problem that Georgia framed around poor diets and how we start to think about poor diets differently, and also about the different outcomes which we talk about differently and don't necessarily link to that same problem. So we've talked about the 10% of children in Britain who live in severely food insecure households. Maggie talked about the 10% of children who start with obese, more of them are overweight, as she said. And everybody has talked about inequality and the fact that these two problems come together around the problem of inequality, and the fact that when you combine a low income with a food environment which is characterised by cheaper food being the most attractive and cheap, you get a really bad outcome for children. Particularly, it means that you have a combination where we do have households that are, at the same time, they're facing periods where they're struggling to put food on the table, and their children might be overweight or obese, and that's all happening at once. And this is a really dangerous environment for children to be growing up in terms of their long-term future. And I think that's the challenge we face. And I think what Corinna's laid out is a vision really for how we can think about the food system differently. And I think it's just worth mentioning very briefly that we have an opportunity coming up with the new agriculture bill, which is one of the, in the Queen's speech, that we will be making new legislation in this parliament to actually think about for Britain what kind of food production system we want and how we want to incentivise that, to use Corinna's language, to make a stronger connection between what we grow and produce in Britain and our diets. And at the moment, the narrative is very strongly around, coming from Defra's, around thinking about agricultural policy in terms of its impact on the environment, and that's hugely important. We don't want to lose that focus. But we need to also be thinking about its impact on public health, how we think about the future of farming in Britain, £3 billion that farmers, for example, currently get through the Common Agricultural Policy. But thinking about that resource fresh, how do we use that in a way which actually starts to make a stronger connection between what we grow and what we eat, and really incentivising the best foods, the highest quality foods, the most nutritious foods, through the system. So I think we have an immediate opportunity on the table in this parliament to think about it in the very way that Corinna is proposing we do, in terms of thinking about the agriculture piece, at least, of the picture, and how we can look at the policies around agriculture in Britain to deliver better outcomes. And then Maggie mentioned advertising, which I think is obviously sort of almost unfinished business, really, on the table as being the sort of key thing that just didn't get it is the childhood obesity strategy, which there's really the moral argument has been won for, in the sense that we already have regulations for children's viewing time, so we've acknowledged that this is a problem for children, so let's do the job properly. And I think there's sort of an immediate opportunity there to continue to press that point, and to try and win that argument in policy terms. And one final point, I think we've heard about the problem of poor diets from multiple settings, and this statistic that one in three people in the world has some form of malnutrition. And I think that creates a huge opportunity for the UK to think about its diet problem alongside a whole raft of other countries that are grappling with a similar set of problems, with a similar set of drivers. That problem might look a little bit different in different settings, but we're all in this together. Country, poor country thing. This is we have a global food system that's not delivering for us, and we need to change it. How do we do that, and how do we make sure that the UK is really alongside other countries of the world, thinking about this problem, leading the way, and thinking about how we frame the food system globally, which is better for us all? And I think we should be laying that challenge down to the government as we go forward.